Come in simplicity. season of fasting. Produce in us the fruit of desperation. God, we want to come with repentant hearts, with surrendered hearts, recognizing that we have put other things above you. Things that don't even hold any value in your kingdom. We've allowed to hold value in our own hearts, in our own lives. And God, we repent. We ask for your forgiveness when we have allowed other things to take the place in our heart. We've loved other things more than you. We've put priority of other things over you. So easily done in our society. God, let us be diligent in doing what Psalm 139 says. That it's a prayer of David that says, search me and know me, God, and see if there's anything in me that offends you. See if there's anything in me that is out of place. God, we seek your face today. Let your blood and righteousness wash over us today. Let us come into a right standing with our Father. He says that we can come boldly to the throne of grace, boldly into his presence. But let's come today. He's not been first and foremost in your heart. Let's put him there. Let's exalt him to the highest place today in our lives. The highest place where he is our number one priority. Our number one love. And if we let us search our hearts and see if there is anything that we are putting value to or fixing our affections upon more than we are him. He is the lover of our soul. He is our first love. He is our first love because he loved us first. Love you, God. Love you, God. Stir in our hearts, burn in our hearts as we seek you, Lord, as we are removing obstacles. We're being obedient. And Lord, forgive us for being grumpy and irritated because we're not having caffeine right now. It's so lame.
We're all addicts.
So God, we just, through this time, through this week, that you take place in our heart. May you come and rule and reign. The highest place. Amen.
Amen. I heard God whisper to me this morning, what if you had God thoughts all day? What if you only had God thoughts all day? And then I opened my Bible and in my list of the scriptures that God had given me between Christmas and New Year's, the next one was out of 2 Corinthians, and Paul said, the scriptures say, who can know the mind of God? And then he says, but you, everybody point to yourself, but I, because that's what Paul was saying, I have the mind of Christ. Let's say that together. I have the mind of Christ. And I know that sometimes it doesn't feel like it, but it's a choice. Deuteronomy 4:6. 6:4. I reversed it. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. Now, does that one say strength there?
It doesn't say
mind. It doesn't say mind.
It says heart, soul, and
strength. Oh, really? Yeah, so when Jesus quoted. Oh, okay. Okay. Anyway, so put your hand on your head again. I've been doing this since the first. Blessing my mind and saying, I have the mind of Christ. I have the mind of Christ. I want to read something from the Passion Translation, because that was where my scripture was from. And this was a whisper this morning. In fact, when I opened it up, it was 46 minutes ago. It says, when you're born again, you move into the supernatural realm. You become a supernatural manifestation walking on the earth. Dust and deity have kissed. You can interact with both worlds. Scripture affirms that hearing God's voice or thinking God's thoughts is natural to a child of God. John chapter 10, verse 4. Would a loving father speak to his child? The answer is yes, every day, every minute. What if we had the thoughts of God all day today? One of the things that really helps us do that is fasting and prayer to get our focus. When Jesus was telling the parable of the sower, he talked about different types of soil. Some are hard packed, been stomped on a lot. Some of you have been stomped on a lot, been run over, get hard packed, and the seed has a hard time breaking through. The other part that he talks about is some of it springs up, but the cares of this world come in and choke it out. What God's trying to do. Fasting and prayer helps us make those cares go away and see nothing in our lives, because we go back to our first love. I love those lines in that song. You're my first love. This is a new year, 2018. In the year of our Lord, 2018. Let's go back to our first love. Let's have the thoughts of God all day. Let them take over those other thoughts that come from the enemy, come from our hurts, that come from the things that are happening in our day. And choose the mind to listen to the mind of Christ. Choose to listen to God's thoughts and hold on to them. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
You can have it all. part of my world. Take this life and breathe on. This heart is now yours. You can have it all. Every part of life and breathe on.
All is stripped away, and I